Hello, my name is Professor Paul Chinley. I'm the head of podiatry at Charles Sturt University, and today we're going to take you through the Community Engagement and Wellness Centre, which is the clinic we run in Albury for our students, for students of podiatry, physiotherapy and speech therapy. Most of the patients here are for the podiatrists, and so they take on responsibility for treating the general public, so anybody can come into this clinic and be seen by students under supervision from someone like myself. The students here treat a multitude of patients, everything from small children through to young adults, sports people. We do a lot of biomechanical assessments and review of people walking and running. We have a large population of people who have diabetes, and diabetes is a major problem in our community in that we get a lot of people who have foot wounds and foot sores caused by their diabetes and poor shoes. So we do a lot of work around that as a podiatrist in this clinic. We've actually managed to reduce the amputation rates in the local area by half since the introduction of our clinic. So this area is our gait laboratory. We do evaluations and assessments of people who are walking. So we evaluate how they move. We have a treadmill to allow us to do that. We have video cameras to enable us to slow the motion down and actually look at each part of the person's walking. Obviously, a foot is a very complicated thing. Got a lot of bones in there. As it moves, it affects the rest of the body. It controls the way the foot is positioned, and the foot position then controls the whole body. So in terms of the types of devices that you would put inside the shoe or you would manufacture as a podiatrist, this is the sort of thing you would do. These are called orthotics. Orthotics go into the shoe. They have a brace on the back here which repositions the foot as it strikes the ground. Now this can be for a small child. You go up to an adult, right the way through to a larger person. This is for a sports person that had a bit more flexibility, but still the control around the back of the foot and how it fits into the shoe. That control is often determined by the pressures on the foot. So here we have an EMED, which is a force pressure measurement system. You can see that there is a pattern of pressure and forces going through the foot. This is a live full speed activity. You can see that there are areas of pink. These areas of pink are indicative of high pressure areas. If I move the scan around a little bit, what we've got here, you can see here's the heel, here's the outside of the foot, this is across the ball of the foot, and you can see the toes. Your foot moves through that relationship, and the pink areas often determine whether the foot is actually likely to have an ulcer. So it's a very interactive system that enables us to adjust somebody's walking pattern, the way their pressure falls on their foot, just by looking at the images here. So this space is our orthotic manufacturing lab, and what the students do in this lab is they actually manufacture devices for patients. So someone who has an ulcer, for example, like this particular person, obviously I haven't amputated this foot, but this is a model. It's a patient who might have a lesion underneath their big toe. We would actually make a device that fits underneath the foot to protect the lesion, and the students learn how to do that. Then we go into how to make an insole, or as you'll see, we make orthotics, which go inside the shoe, which are for a number of different types of patients, everybody from small children right the way through to 99-year-olds, and everybody in between. Podiatrists can treat all manner of foot and gait and lower limb problems. This is just one example. And the students will learn hands-on experience in this laboratory under supervision from someone like myself. This space is for rehabilitation. One of the things that podiatrists can do is exactly the same as a physiotherapist can do. They can offer up exercises, they can go through regimes of improvement of quality of life, things like improving the range of motion, improving the way that somebody might cycle, for example, or use an exercise bike. All these things are within the remit of a podiatrist. As a podiatrist, we can inject people, we can prescribe drugs, we send off for x-rays. Effectively, we're a doctor of the foot. It's a lot more than just cutting toenails, and really important to emphasise that. Podiatry is a four-year degree. It's important that you recognise that it's a doctor of the foot. So that's really important. And rehab of the patient and their lower limb is all part of what a podiatrist does. Okay, so if we whetted your appetite for being a podiatrist or thinking about it as a career, feel free to make contact directly or go onto the website, csu.edu.au, find out more about podiatry. It might be the career for you.